Now it's time for our story time. And if the children will go around and collect those green flags that the people will hold up. And then Linda is going to have our story today.
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away, behold, all things have become new.
Thank you. Did you believe that promise? Okay, this is my first story time, so please forgive me. How is everyone doing this Sabbath morning, by the way?
Good.
Good? Okay. Who believes in God? Okay. Who believes that there is power in the name of Jesus? Breathe worlds into existence. Okay, you have a good crowd out there. How about a literal six-day creation? And he rested on the Sabbath day. Do you know why he rested? Do you think he was tired? He wanted us to rest. He sanctified the Sabbath day and he made it holy. And that's why we're here today, to celebrate creation and its rest. Okay. He's not only the God of the universe who made everything that you see and everything in existence, but he wants to be a personal God with you, as personal as the person sitting right next to you. He wants a personal walk with you. That's very important, that we have a personal walk with him. And that we cultivate our minds, the gardens of our heart, to have them grow in Jesus. Important? very important. Okay, today I'm going to tell you a true story. But let me share you a little bit. It's the story of Jack. And I'll share you a little bit of Jack's story and a little bit of the background of Jack's story. One day, I woke up with a thought on my mind, even before my morning prayers. Prison ministries. What? Prison ministries? What's that all about? Well, I thought it was a dream. I was waking out of a dream, and that was just something from my dream. So I kind of pushed it aside and didn't think about it anymore. But then not too long after that, once again, I wake up with prison ministries, the thought of prison ministries on my mind. What? That makes no sense to me at all. So, I kind of put it on the back burner. Have you heard that, the back burner? It's kind of in the back of my mind. So, once again, not too long later, I woke up with prison ministries on my mind. So I thought, well, this must be the Holy Spirit trying to make an impression to me. So I thought I'd go and ask somebody. I asked Mr. Race first, and then I asked Mr. Duvalier, and one of them suggested that I call a conference. You know where the conference is? It's over in Orlando. So I called the conference, and miracle of miracles, someone was there named Donna. She just went on and on what a miracle it was that I called that day, because she only came in once or twice a year for supplies. So I thought, wow, that's amazing. That's got to be divine intervention. So when I talked to Donna, she mentioned it to the head of prison ministries. And before I knew it, he was down here giving us a sermon and teaching the volunteers who wanted to go into Tomoka, which is our local prison, all about how we act and how we do when we go in there, what we do. So, after that, we had five devotees that wanted to go in. And we met Jack the first time we went in. Jack came up and greeted all of us and shook our hand, and he sat in the very back of the chapel. So slowly but surely, Jack moved to the front row. And every time we went in, he would come and shake our hands and greet us and welcome us to the prison. And we got to know Jack better and better every time we went in. So, the next thing that we did was listen to the Holy Spirit every time and pray before we went in so we would know what to say. Now, none of us knew what to think because none of us had ever done this before. So, nobody knew exactly what we were going to go through. We were kind of scared, because they had wire on the fences and all kinds of razor wire and stuff like that. But we went in, and every day we prayed that we would grow and learn how to do this. And soon it became, well, we still get nervous a little bit, but as we got to know Jack a little more, he asked me if I would pray for him because he told me that he had a temper and a problem with authority. Do you ever lose your temper when something goes wrong? Well, I do. So we prayed for him and prayed for him. And then after about 3 years, a little over 3 years, he shared with us that he was getting out of jail. Isn't that great? I I was so thankful and so happy for him, and we were all just thanking him and wishing him well, and he gave every one of us a little piece of paper with his name and address on it so we could get in touch with him. And he wrote every one of us a letter after he got out and signed it, "Be strong in the Lord and the power of his might." Isn't that beautiful? And he told us also that he just wanted to stay strong in the Lord. And after we got his letters, some of us wrote him letters back. And Tom and I went to see him, and he's in Gainesville. So we went to Gainesville to see him. And he just said that was just, nothing could crush his joy that day. He was so happy that we came to see him. So that tells me that we have to follow up on our prison ministries. If somebody gets out and contacts us, that's not the end of our ministry. We have to get in touch with them and show them that we still care about them. So now Tom and I talk to him every day. I send him a Bible text every day to encourage him. But he encourages us. It's just such a beautiful thing to see when God changes someone's life. And my prayer was to God that he would show us just one person. That we would show Jesus through this one person, and he would show us the difference that was made in his life. So God answered our prayer, my prayer. And God answered his prayer, because his prayer was for God to make him the real deal. Do you know what that means, the real deal? Make him authentic and really walk the walk, not just talk the talk, because he'd seen so many people just talk the talk. So he is the real deal. And right before our eyes, we've seen changes in this man I can't quite explain, but he has made a 180-degree change in his attitude and his temper and his temperament. And he just has blessed us so much. And I just thank the Lord for an answer to prayer. And I would ask every one of you to listen to Jesus. He might not impress you to do the same thing that we did, but he will impress you to do something. So let's pray, every one of us, that he will bring someone into our lives. Does that mean Gilbert? Gilbert might have someone into his life every day. And you can make a difference. Maybe the only one who can make a difference in that person's life. Would you like that? Would anyone like to pray? You would? Okay, let's pray.
Lord Jesus, thank you for this wonderful day. Jesus, amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much.